Does hemophilia run in your family? Women with close family members who have hemophilia are very likely to have inherited the hemophilia gene. Until recently, it was widely believed that females don't have symptoms of hemophilia, that they are only carriers of the gene. But that belief is often incorrect. In 2010, the International Society on Thrombosis and Hemostasis found that female carriers had higher mean bleeding scores and lower clotting factor levels than other women their age. The Canadian Hemophilia Society has found that a substantial percentage of female carriers can suffer abnormal bleeding due to injury, surgery, or childbirth, even when their factor levels are in the range of people without hemophilia. They also found that 57% of carriers experienced heavy, prolonged menstrual bleeding. In the United States, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention found that female carriers often had symptoms of abnormal bleeding, including joint bleeds that limited joint mobility as early as the preteen years. The World Federation of Hemophilia recognizes that female carriers can have bleeding symptoms similar to men with mild hemophilia. They define a symptomatic carrier as a woman whose factor levels are 40 to 60% of normal and who has some of these symptoms. While one of the most common symptoms is heavier and prolonged menstrual bleeding, any of the symptoms shown here could be a sign that you are a symptomatic carrier. If this sounds like you, what should you do? According to the World Federation of Hemophilia, you should talk to your doctor and have your factor levels checked to know if precautions need to be taken. For example, you may need to take steps to reduce your bleeding risk during pregnancy. And you might want to keep a medical alert card or bracelet on you in case of an emergency. If you know a woman who is experiencing symptoms of hemophilia, please share this information with her. To learn more, visit signsofbleeding.com to find useful information and links to other resources about carriers and women with hemophilia. All of us in the hemophilia community must work to increase awareness of women who are symptomatic carriers so they know they're not alone and can have better access to testing and treatment.